friend of the month show Adrenalize. Yes, friends, Adrenalize, we always invite such entrepreneurs, coaches, professionals who have achieved something special and they want to share their story with us. So today we are having Francesca Richardson from Maryland, USA, inner wisdom therapist, psychotherapist, hypnotherapist, 30 years experience, psychoanalyst and accelerator resolution therapy practitioner. She is known for her coaching skills, helping people to learn how to heal and grow emotionally and spiritually. She helps women manage their caring power and use it for others. Welcome to the show, Francesca.
Thank you, Charu. Thank you so much. I am so excited to be here to talk with you.
Thank you so much for your time. Please share about yourself, Francesca. Francesca, what's the story you are having? Love to know.
Yes, I have been a psychotherapist for over 30 years. Okay. That means I help people with anxiety, depression, grieving, relationship issues. And in my time, I've really noticed that there are many caring and sensitive people, nurturing people, particularly women, who give and give. And sometimes they give so much that they end up depleting themselves.
Oh.
So I really, you know, like to focus on helping them to recognize the magic of their caring, the power of their caring, so that they can, they don't deplete themselves, they take care of themselves, and they recognize that their caring changes others' reality and that it's powerful. Often it goes unrecognized. So that's what I focus on.
Fantastic. Caring somehow comes as innate quality of any woman. And I strongly believe that every woman is having that innate quality, but using that quality for doing magic, for doing healing mindfully, this is something first time I'm hearing. Very interesting. So what unique work you are doing and what's your vision?
Yes. I think that the caring, because it is innate to many people, many women, many women are intuitive. They feel others' feelings. They're sensitive. They don't want to set limits. They don't want to say no to anyone because they worry about hurting feelings. They feel others' feelings, and so they want to help the other person with their feelings. That means that they sometimes abandon themselves. They sometimes forget that they need care too. So I want, number one, for them to care for themselves, but number two, for them also to recognize that they have a powerful gift, and as a gift, they need to manage it, care for it. And it's often unrecognized how powerful caring is, that through listening, through empathizing, through helping others see another way forward, that you're changing reality. You're changing another person's reality. And that is real power. So I want that to be recognized by women, by those caring, sensitive people, and by the world.
Very interesting. I like the way you said that women have to care for themselves first, because they often get depleted of that innate quality as it goes away for others. So once we are caring for ourselves and having that power strong, I think we can use it much better way. As a coach, how can you bring a difference in your coachee's life, and what other benefits she will be getting under your coaching?
Yes, wonderful. So one of the things is that I have these years of experience. I also did research on family caregivers of dementia patients. And in my research, I looked at theories and others' research. I found that I looked at Carol Gilligan's research, her research on the ethic of care. I looked at Arlie Hochschild's work on emotional labor, what she called what women do in taking care of others' emotions. It's called emotional labor. And she called it labor because it does take work. It's effortful. So I help women in individuals and in groups to recognize that power, recognize their own power, and begin to care for themselves differently.
Fantastic. So friends, take a note. you have to learn this caring for yourself and for others, how you can use it for healing. Because in present times, very strange diseases are coming. Mostly everybody is facing some health challenge. So then why we don't use our power, inner power, which we have got from supreme power, and we get mindful about it and learn how to heal ourselves and others naturally. It's such a beautiful work you are doing, Dr. Francesca. It's amazing. Can you share some message for our readers?
Yes. Self-care is often thought to be selfish. I can't tell you the number of women who say to me, well, I can't stop and take care of myself. I can't take a nap. I'll go 12 hours without eating. I will, go 3 days without taking care of myself. I can't tell you the number of women, both in my practice and in my research, that I find just feel that self-care is selfish, and that self-sacrifice is the highest good. That's a mistaken belief, that self-sacrifice is the highest good. We need to really balance self-care with giving to others. I often use that metaphor that you hear when you go on an airplane, that you have to give yourself the oxygen first so that you can then help others around you, your children or whoever. If you don't give yourself oxygen first, you will soon be depleted. So it's the same in your life. You do have to take care of yourself. And if you're, if you're a caring, sensitive, intuitive, empathic person, you do have to manage that power, that ability, so that you can continue to do that and not run out, not become burnt out. You want to be able to continue moving forward. It's a marathon, not a sprint, all this caring that we do.
Yeah. Wow, this is so powerful and such a beautiful example you have said. Definitely in planes, when we are there, we are asked to put the oxygen mask on ourselves first and then to give to our kids. So this applies in the real life also, friends. First, we have to make ourselves strong, healthy, and we have to have those powers for ourselves first, which we can give to others. And this caring power is such a supreme power, which everybody is having. So start, first of all, caring for yourself, and then use this power to heal others. Wow, such a fantastic sharing. Thank you so much for your time, Francesca. All the best, and I wish you all the success. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Charo.